So the image blurring example that we've been using actually illustrates another important kind of communication pattern called stencil. Stencil codes update each element in an array using neighboring array elements in a fixed pattern called the stencil. This is the stencil pattern we saw before. It's technically known as a 2D von Neumann stencil. Let me reiterate how this worked, and this time use color coding a little differently to show you what's going on. So here I've color coded the threads to show you which one is going to be working on which output element. So I'll choose the blue one to be writing into this value. Here's where the red one's going to write its output value. Here's where the green thread will write its output value. And if you look at what's going to happen, each of these threads is going to read from several locations in memory surrounding the corresponding input value, and those locations are defined by the stencil. So the blue thread will do a gather from these threads, and then the red colored thread will do a gather from the overlapping neighborhood. And then the green thread will do a gather from this neighborhood, and so on. Eventually, there'll be some other thread who's responsible for, say, writing to this value. And that thread is going to go and access these values. So something you're going to notice right away is that there's a lot of data reuse going on. Many threads are accessing and computing from the same data. And exploiting that data reuse is something we're going to use later on when you're working on your homework assignment. We're going to try to exploit that reuse to speed up your homework assignment. Now, there are other common stencil patterns. For example, you might read from all of the neighboring elements, including the diagonal elements, and that would be called a 2D Moore pattern. Now, there are also 3D analogs of these. So for my next trick, I'm going to attempt to draw a 3D von Neumann stencil, which is sort of a kind of a cross shape and extending in all three dimensions. Hopefully you can see that from my drawing. So speaking of data reuse, here's a quick quiz. Can you figure out how many times a given input element in the array will be read when applying each of these stencils?